here at Kaminsky Boxing. Right before Joshua Usyk Tolik, I interviewed you and you told me Usyk wins easy. Why did you say that? What did you think of the fight?
So, two things. Usyk, he's a boxer. He's a no puncher. He's a boxer. He have heavy punch, but still boxer. And that's what I prefer in boxing. That's what I like in boxing. Box. So when you try to kill as a Joshua with power, with his huge biceps, huge shoulder, like he said after fight, I'm not Rocky Marciano, I'm not Muhammad Ali, I'm Joshua. I'm Anthony Joshua, I'm big guy. He's like bodybuilder in the gym, in the ring. And the Joshua, great fighter. With his body, he's a great fighter. But Usyk bucks, he just bucks with Joshua. But couple times, Usyk had hard time.
Ninth round.
Hard time.
Joshua looked better to me than the first fight.
Oh, the best.
But what happened after the fight? So Usyk won, and then Joshua threw the belts, he got mad.
At Joshua threw the belts, he got disappointed on himself. That's what my vision on all this situation. He got disappointed on all himself. This is very emotionally. This is boxing. Who been in the ring, who lost ever one time in his life, he knows how you disappoint after whole training camps, after whole program, whole diet, whole power training.
I understand that. It didn't bother me.
And you losing fight and you got disappointed just because somebody better than you. And Joshua said, "Hey, Usyk, you motherfucker, how you won the fight? I don't understand. I took best coach ever, Robert Garcia. I took very nice sparring partner. The camp was amazing. Everybody was beautiful. Everything was beautiful, and you still won. How?" So I'm really disappointed, and I throw all his belt, and he throw all his belt to the trash. So, but do not forget, same time, he made $40 million plus.
Usyk's a great fighter.
And Usyk, great. He lost to who? He lost one of the best fighters.
Now,
the
pound for pound king for Ring Magazine. They call
Ring
it,
Magazine. Yeah. Okay, this is what fight Ring Magazine built.
I still think it's Canelo. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, so and Joshua lost. Fine. So this is real boxing. This was real boxing. This real match between two best of the best fighter. One of them lose. One of them. It's split decision. It's still split decision.
Let me ask you this: Joshua and Wilder, Usyk and Fury.
Usyk and Fury, I didn't see. Okay, one. This is my opinion. Again, nobody, like, don't judge me, please. I don't want to.
They will, but it's okay.
They will judge me. I understand people like to judge.
They like to talk shit.
It's their own opinion. But if Josh, like, look, let me go. Did Joshua start first round? Amazing. Second round, amazing. Third round, amazing. Four round, but okay. Till five round, it was beautiful. So. Why? He threw jab. He was amazing with his
went to
jab.
The body. Yeah.
Body jab. There was move, stick to the plan. Yeah. And Robert Garcia. After six out, Robert Garcia screaming on the corner. Jab, jab, jab. He stopped. He just blocked. No jab, nothing. Look, now we go back to right to your question. Fury. Tyson Fury. Tyson Fury jabbing. And look what happened. Anthony Joshua was jabbing Usyk. And Usyk wouldn't know what to do. And what Usyk did, angles, and Joshua make a step back and jab again. It was perfectly fine. It was perfectly fine.
If he stuck with it, yeah.
If he stuck to the plan. But he didn't. He missed one punch, second punch. Like Mike Tyson said, you have plan till you missed 1-2 punches. When you start missing 1-2 punches, you lose all your plan.
So it sounds like you...
And like I said, question is, so the Tyson Fury jab, experienced fighter, very experienced, great fighter, reach, size, everything. He's gonna win Usyk.
Okay, and what about Wilder and Joshua?
Wilder, Joshua. This is great fight for Joshua. Great fight.
Big fight for all the fans. I like it.
And big fight for Wilder. And Wilder is nice, like he's gonna be back to the ring with some different fight. I believe I saw already in September something.
October 15th for Robert Alanius, yeah. Who has 30 wins, 22 knockouts.
Yeah, so something like rust out from his skin after all this.
I went to visit him this week. He looked great. Totally. He did 40 rounds with no sweat. Like, he was
That's hard. Amazing. Like, again, we do not forget, he, with full respect to Deontay Wilder, he's a football player. With full respect, he's a football player. To become from transaction from football player to two boxers, nobody says it's impossible. They're possible, but takes time. Now probably this is his time. Now probably
he's
this is his
Malik
time.
Malik Scott doing a great job.
Malik Scott, yeah. I just talked to Malik Scott yesterday.
Very nice guy. I like Malik.
I like Malik. I talked to him yesterday and I asked him, he told me I work with Wilder, but I told him maybe you can spar David a little bit, like 4 or 5 rounds with your slick tank and everything. He told me, Tolik, I would like to help you in 2 weeks.
Okay.
So we'll see.
All right. There you have it. Tolik Kaminsky, where do people follow you? Follow the gym?
Yeah, you can come to the gym, Kaminsky Boxing, to receive the 7023 9 a.m. to 8 p.m.
All right, come here, get in shape. Stay tuned. This is the house of Blueface, too, and he's getting ready for a big fight on
Blueface.
September 10th. Blueface, you understand?
Blueface again, start sparring again.
Whose dog is that? You?
By the way, David got new dog. You saw his dog?
Yeah.
Yeah, very pretty dog.
Very pretty dog. It's like my dog. It's going to cost him a lot of money because it's high end.
They already cost a lot.
Why?
He bought it.
He didn't get it for free? No. He gave them a shout out?
No. It's expensive dog. It's.
It makes him happy. Dogs are
breeder. Yeah. Money, it's not a big deal. Just make him happy. This most important.
That's true. He's happy.
And discipline. The dog makes him happy.
Stay tuned. Elisek Back reporting.